projections preserve the database consistency, and we proved also by using serial schedules that the execution of serial schedules of a set of transaction always preserve database consistency. It always preserve database consistency. Now there are certain schedule like concurrent schedule possibly whose result same as that of serial schedule. There are some concurrent schedule whose result is same as that of serial schedule. Those concurrent schedules are called as serializable. Those concurrent schedules are also called as serializable schedule. Okay, so what is serializable schedule or serializability? A possibly concurrent schedule is serializable if it is equivalent to a serial schedule. So if you see the previous four examples of schedules, that is S1, S2, S3 and S4. Out of these, we have to only focus on schedule 3 and schedule number 4. And we have to check which schedule is a serializable schedule here. You see, check the output of schedule 3. It is same as that of previous schedule S1 and S2. Schedule 3 is a concurrent schedule, but its result is same as that of the serial schedule. That's why we can say that schedule number 3 is a serializable schedule. It is a serializable schedule. We can convert schedule 3 to previous schedule 1 or schedule 2 by swap of non-conflicting instructions. That we'll see later how to convert this concurrent schedule to a serial schedule. So here we are understanding the definition of serializable schedule. What is serializable schedule? It is always possibly a concurrent schedule whose result is same as that of the serial schedule. You can see the definition. A possibly concurrent schedule is serializable if it is equivalent to a serial schedule. So here we can say that schedule number 3, whose result is same as that of schedule number 1 and 2, which were the serial schedule, that's why we can say that this particular concurrent schedule is serializable. But if you focus on schedule number 4, this is also concurrent schedule, but it does not preserve database consistency, and the result of schedule number 4 does not match with the result of schedule number 1 and 2. We cannot convert this particular schedule into a serial schedule. Its results are not matching to the schedule number 1 and schedule number 2. That's why we can say that schedule number 4 is not a conflict serializable schedule, or it is not a serializable schedule. Have you understood, student, what is serializable schedule? Then only we can move to the next point. If you understand this, then only we can move to the another topic. Then only we can understand different topic and the problem of serializability. Please write your answer. Have you understood what do you mean by serializable schedule? It is always a concurrent schedule. Serializable schedule is always a concurrent schedule whose result is similar to the serial schedule. Then only we call such concurrent schedule as a serializable schedule. During check of consistency in the previous section, we noticed that this schedule 3 is equivalent to schedule number 1, whose result is same as schedule number 1, which was a serial schedule. You can see here, this is schedule number 1, which is a serial schedule. This result and schedule number 3's result, both are matching. That's why we can consider this particular schedule S3, which is a concurrent schedule, as a serial schedule. Now coming to the next topic of serializability, there are different forms of schedule equivalence give rise to the notation notion of conflict serializability and view serializability. It means that there are two types of serializability in databases. One is conflict serializability and another is view serializability. Before going to understand what are the transactions which conflict to each other and to see what is conflict serializability, before that we should know the simplified view of transaction. What happens when a transaction executes? What operations it's going to execute? So we ignore operation other than read and write instructions. Our transaction always focuses on the two operations, that is read and write. We only consider those operations. Then we assume that transaction may perform arbitrary computations on data in local buffer in between read and writes. So what are the operations that happens between read and write only will be considered and others will be ignored. Our simplified schedules consist of only read and write instructions. So ultimately your focus should be on read and write operations that happens in between transactions. Okay, so let us see now in conflict serializability which instructions of the transaction conflicts to each other. To understand this particular slide, I have given you one example in the previous lectures also, that is the joint account of husband and wife, say, and both are having, suppose, the ATM cards. They enter into different ATM centers and suppose at the same time they perform a read operation. They check the balance of their account. Checking the balance means they are reading the account balance. If both the transactions perform read operation on any data item, then they will get the same amount balance that they has in the account, right? So they do not conflict because they get the same result. They get same result. It means that when two transaction instructions perform a read operation on a particular data item, they do not conflict. Correct? But they will conflict only when if someone perform read operation and someone perform write operation, or any one of them perform write operation, then there is definitely a conflict. It is because the transaction will perform write operations first and the transaction which perform read operation immediately after that will going to get the updated account balance. Means whatever the balance previously was there in the account, that was not been displayed, and the current balance will be displayed. So this type of writing into the databases is called as blind writes. This is also example of a blind write. Let us now understand the transaction, their instructions, and which transaction instructions conflicts to each other. Consider there are two transactions, TI and TJ. And transaction can have n number of statements into it, means instructions into it. So consider that there are transaction instructions II and IJ of transaction TI and TJ respectively. Conflict, these two instructions conflict if and only if there exists some data item Q accessed by both instructions II and IJ. And at least one of them perform a write operation on data item Q. It means that out of this instructions I and IJ, if any one of them perform write operation on data item Q, then they will definitely going to conflict to each other. Let's see. There are only four possibilities in between these two transactions, instruction, that is read and write, right? So for two read and write operation, there are four possibilities. Read, write, write, read, and write. Let us first see the first statement. Suppose instruction II perform read operation on data item Q, and similarly IJ also perform read operation on data item Q. It means both the instructions from both the transaction performs read operation on data item Q. Then we can say that they do not conflict because they will get the correct answer, same answer on their side, right? II and IJ don't conflict to each other. Let us see the another statement. second statement, where II perform read operation, whereas IJ perform write operation. So the conflict, because one of them is going to perform write operation and they will going to get updated balances, but they will not get what they expect from the database, right? Updated balances will be same. Now see the third operation, where II instruction of PI performs read operation on data item Q, whereas IJ instruction of PJ transaction perform read operation on data item Q. Here also the conflict, because one of them is performing write operation. And the last possibility is that II perform write operation on data item Q. Similarly, IJ also perform the write operation on data item Q. Here also the conflict, because whenever there is a write operation among any one of the transaction instruction, then they conflict. The conflict arises because these instructions are happening concurrently, parallelly. Because of that, the conflict arises. Indeedly, a conflict between II and IJ forces a logical temporal order between them. If II and IJ are consecutive in a schedule and they do not conflict, suppose. Consider that these two instructions, II and IJ, are consecutive in the schedule. It means they are placed one after the another. Consecutive means one after the another. And they do not conflict, suppose. Their results would remain the same, even if they had been interchanged in a schedule. It means that if there are two instructions perform the operations on the same data item, and if they do not conflict, we can interchange their order in the schedule. We can interchange their order into the schedule, and while interchanging this, it does not going to harm our database. There would not be any changes into the database. It means that is possible. You can swap these two instruction order in the concurrent execution of the transactions. That is possible. Now, have you understood this particular slide, students? When the conflict arises, when two transactions are executed simultaneously, when the conflict arises in the instructions of TI and TJ, the conflict arises only when any one of them perform a write operation. If you perform read operation on a data item, there is no conflict. And to understand this, I have given you the example of a joint account of husband and wife in a bank. Right? If they perform read operations in different ATM centers at the same time, they will get the same account balance. There is no conflict. But suppose husband perform read operation, and then before husband perform write operation, wife performs write operation, suppose, then there will be a conflict. It means that suppose account balance of both the husband and wife is say 10,000 initially. Wife wants to withdraw 1,000 rupees, where husband wants to withdraw 2,000 rupees from the bank account. Initially, suppose both perform read operation on data item Q, they will get 10,000 balance on their screen. Now suppose wife withdraws 1,000 rupees before the husband withdraws 2,000 rupees from the bank. The transaction of wife suppose complete first, and she performs write operation on the joint account. Then the updated balance would be 9,000 in the bank. After that, suppose the husband transaction perform the write operation. It means 2,000 have been successfully withdrawn from the bank, and now updated balance would be 7,000. So husband get confused that initially it was showing 10,000, then I withdrawn only 2,000, and available balance should be 8,000 in the bank, but it is showing me 7,000. This happened because of the conflicting instructions. This happened because blind writes that happened between two transactions instructions, because they executed concurrently, parallelly. Now tell me, have you understood serializability? Here we have seen this particular statement. This is very, very important. if two transactions are consecutive, two transaction instructions are consecutive in a schedule and they do not conflict, suppose, then we can interchange their sequence in the execution of the schedule. So that is very, very important to understand the conflict schedule. Let us understand what is conflict schedule. Consider there are two schedules, S and S dash. S and S dash, there are two schedules. If a schedule S can be transformed into a schedule S dash by a series of non-conflicting instructions, then we can say that schedule S and S dash are conflict equivalent. So this is very important that in a schedule S, if it is possible to transform that particular schedule into S dash by a series of non-conflicting instructions, then we can say that both those schedules are conflict equivalent. And always student remember that the schedule S is concurrent schedule in conflict serializability. Schedule S is a concurrent schedule. If you are able to convert any concurrent schedule into a serial schedule by a swap of non-conflicting instructions, then we can say that the given concurrent schedule is conflict equivalent or conflict serializable. Conflict serializable. So you can see the second statement on the slide. We say that a schedule S is conflict serializable if it is conflict equivalent to a serial schedule. Now let us see one example of concurrent schedule and how to convert that concurrent schedule into serial schedule by a swap of non-conflicting instruction. This particular line is very, very important, student. Swap of non-conflicting instruction. You can swap only non-conflicting instruction. You cannot swap conflicting instruction. That is very important in conflict serializability. Let us see now one example of converting any concurrent schedule into serial schedule. We have seen this particular schedule S3 before also. We have seen four schedule examples and we tested for consistency. Out of that, this is our schedule number 3, wherein transaction T1 and T2, they are happening concurrently. Because if you see, T1 is perform read and write operation, and then the CPU goes to transaction T2, where it again perform read and write operation on data item B. Again, it comes back to transaction T1, there it perform read B and read write B operation, and then it goes to transaction T2 perform read B and write B operation. So definitely, this is a concurrent schedule, right? Our job is to convert this particular schedule S3 to a serial schedule like this. On the right hand side, if you see this particular schedule that is converted into serial schedule, this is a serial schedule, schedule number 6, where all the instructions of T1 are happening before T2 starts. It means that here T2 is followed by T1, and the effect of schedule number 6 and whereas the effect of schedule number 3 is same. It means the output of schedule number 3 and the output of schedule number 6 is same. When the outputs are same of a concurrent schedule and of a serial schedule, then we can say that the schedule, concurrent schedule given to us is conflict serializable. It is conflict serializable or it is conflict equivalent to schedule number 6. Now let's see how we can do this, how we can convert a concurrent schedule into a serial schedule. I'll show you in the Excel sheet now. Here, is it visible, student? Or shall I increase the font size here? Is it visible to all of you? Now please check, is it visible? Thank you. Okay. Let us understand now. This is a concurrent schedule given to us. Our job is to convert this concurrent schedule into a serial schedule. My question to all of you first. This is our first instruction. This is the second instruction. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Instruction 1 and 2 belongs to T1. Instruction 3 and 4 belongs to T2. 5 and 6 belongs to T1. 7 and 8 belongs to T2. Now my question to all of you is that, tell me any two consecutive instructions which are not conflicting here. You can understand by instruction number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Give me one example of two consecutive instructions here in this particular schedule which are not conflicting to each other. You have to see the instructions given in T1 and T2. Check it properly. If they are working on the same data item and if they perform a read operation, there is no conflict. If they are working on the same data item and any one of them perform write operation, then they are conflicting. So my question to all of you is that, give me example of one example of two instructions which are not conflicting here, but they are consecutive and they are not conflicting. You can write your answer in the chat box. Nobody is replying. Check the schedule. Consecutive का meaning क्या होता है? Suppose this is instruction number 2 and this is instruction number 3. They are consecutive, one after the another, right? Let us check for the conflicting instructions here. Instruction 2 and instruction 3, are they conflicting or not? Tell me. Can we perform a swap operation between instruction 2 and instruction 3? Are they conflicting here? They are working on the same data item. A. One is performing write, another is performing read. So are they conflicting here? Right or no? They are conflicting. Good. They are conflicting. Bharat is correct. They are conflicting. But it means that if they are conflicting, we cannot perform swapping of these two instructions. Understand this very well. Write A and read A, they are working on the same data item and one of them is performing write operation, and because of that they are conflicting instructions. We cannot swap two conflicting instructions. We can only swap two non-conflicting instructions. You can see the definition of conflict serializability. We can swap non-conflicting instruction. If a schedule S can be transformed into schedule S dash by a series of non-conflicting instruction. So this is very important. Swap of non-conflicting instruction. So our job is to identify which are non-conflicting instructions here. So it means that there is no possibility of swapping of instruction 2 and instruction 3. That's why it is also there with this instruction 2 and instruction 4. Let us concentrate on instruction number 4, that is write A, and instruction number 5 in T1 transaction, that is read B. Now let us focus on this. I will change the color of these two to understand that we are here. We are matching these two transactions. Now tell me, are these two transactions conflicting or not? One is performing a write operation, another is performing a read operation. Are they conflicting here? Tell me. Right, yes or no? Are they conflicting instruction? One is performing write and another is performing read operation. T2 is performing write operation on A, whereas T1 is performing read operation on B. Instruction number 4 and instruction number 5 in this schedule. Are they conflicting instructions or not? Okay. Vishaka and Snehal has given me the answer that they are conflicting. Please, all other student also you give your opinion. This is very important. जिसको ये समझ में आया वो जीत गया आज. ध्वनि शाह, वेरी गुड. She is saying not conflict. जानवी नाम्बिया, नॉन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, वेरी गुड. एनी अदर स्टूडेंट वॉन्ट्स टू एड योर आंसर, यू कैन राइट योर आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स. ये समझना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. राइट ए ऑपरेशन इज परफॉर्म बाय ट्रांजेक्शन टी टू, वेर एज रीड बी ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म बाय ट्रांजेक्शन टी वन. One is performing write operation, another is performing read operation, and it is very, very, very important that on which data item are they working on the same data item? No, they are not working on same data item. If they are not working on the same data item, there is no conflict. Though there it is write or read operation, consecutive as well as they do not conflict. Then only we can perform sort of those two operations. We can interchange their sequence into the schedule. So here is the possibility that instruction number 4, which perform write operation on A in transaction T2, whereas instruction number 5, which perform read operation on B in transaction T1. Here they perform read and write, but they both are working on different data items. So that's why there is no conflict between these two. Have you understood? Ye conflict kab hota tha? If they works on the same data item, then there is a conflict. But right now they are not working on same data item. That's why there is no conflict. Okay. Now let us swap the order of these two. Why we are swapping these two sequences? Because our job is to convert this particular schedule into a serial schedule. It means that all the instructions of T1 must be executed and then T2 must start. So that way we have to convert, right? So I can swap, I can interchange write A instruction of transaction T2 and read B instruction of transaction T1. So I am changing it here. So we will get intermediate schedule. I will change it name as S4C, and now here I will perform read B and here I will perform write A, and now I will remove these two because we changed their sequences. So this was our previous schedule S3, and we perform the operation of swap operation between fourth and fifth instructions of this schedule, write A and read B, and after swapping those instructions I got this intermediate schedule S4. Now let us focus on this. Can I perform the swap between read A and read B operation? Focus instruction number, I'll change the color again here. So this is one and this is another instruction. Can we perform the swap between these two? Focus on schedule number 4, instruction number 3 and instruction number 4. They both perform read operation. If they perform read operation, there is no conflict on the same data item. But right now they perform read operation, but on the different data items, there is no conflict. They are not conflicting. So can we perform swap of these two operations, students? Yes. If they are not conflicting, we can do the swapping of it. So I'll do that here. Instead of this is your schedule number 5, intermediate schedule number 5. So here I'm writing it. Read B, and here I should write read A. Correct. And I have to remove this from here and this from here. That means that when I swap this to read A and read B operation, this would be the next schedule, intermediate schedule. So slowly, slowly, you can see all the instructions of T1 are going up and T2 are going down. So that after some steps, you will find all the instructions are T1 will be there first and then T2 going to start. So that would be considered as a serial scale. Now my question to all of you, can we perform the swap of write A operation of T2 and write B operation? Understand this, I'll again change the color. This is write A, this is write B operation. Are they conflicting to each other, these two instructions? Write your answer in the chat box. These two instructions, write A and write B in schedule number 5. Write A and write B. This is instruction number 6. Are they conflicting, write A and write B? No, they are not conflicting, because if you see, though they are performing write operation, but they are working on different data items, they are not conflicting. You can swap those non-conflicting instructions. Now let us swap these two, sequence of these two instructions. So you will get the intermediate schedule number, say 6. And here, I will bring it down, write the operation. And write B operation will be shifted up from transaction T1. I'll remove this and this from the schedule, and this would be the intermediate picture. Correct? Now, we got this particular schedule, S6. Let us focus on the fourth instruction in this schedule, that is read A operation, which is there in T2 transaction, write B operation in T1. Let me change the color of this too, so that you'll understand which operation is happening now. We want to swap these two. Can we swap these two instruction, students? Read A operation in S6 and write B operation in S6. Instruction number 4 and instruction number 5. Are they conflicting to each other? Can we swap these two? Write your answer in the chat box. They are not conflicting. They are not conflicting. That's why we can swap. Correct? So let us do that. They are not conflicting. So we can swap the order in this execution. So if you do that, what will happen? Write B operation will go up and read A will come down. And I'll remove this from both the transaction, write read A and write B. We change their sequences, we interchange their sequences. Let us focus on now both of this. After doing this particular swapping operation in S6, and we got our last schedule, that is S7, we are able to convert schedule number S3, which was a serial schedule, which was a concurrent schedule, by a swap of non-conflicting instructions. We are able to convert it into schedule number 7, which is a serial schedule, because all the instructions of T1 are executing before T2 start. It means that T1 and then T2. T2 is followed by T1. So whenever it is possible to convert any concurrent schedule into a serial schedule like this, S7, S3 is converted to S7, then we can say that the given concurrent schedule S3 is conflict serializable schedule.